everybody. My name is Brandy Avery. I am the co-CEO of Keys to Black Wealth. And today I want to come to you with several keys about credit and credit education. So let's get into it. Chapter one, I want to first talk to you about what actually makes up a credit score. A credit score is a mathematical calculation. That score can be anywhere from a 300 to an 850. The most important keys to remember about your credit score and that mathematical calculation is the higher the score, the lower your risk, and the lower the risk, the higher the score. So just remember, when you're going out and you're applying for loans, when you're trying to get a mortgage, when you're trying to get a car, lenders want to see your credit score at a healthy 700 or higher in order for you to get the best interest rate and also in order for you to get the actual approval. Next chapter. So let's talk about the credit score breakdown. Let's talk about exactly what that pie chart is that you see out there. It's the credit score composition chart. That composition chart is actually telling you exactly how your credit calculation is computed. The largest part of your credit score is going to be 35% of your credit score, which is going to be your on-time, every single time payment histories. So lenders want to see that you are making your bills, your payments on time, every single time, and that makes up the largest part of your score. Remember, if you fall behind on a score, on a payment, your score can drop anywhere from 50 to 100 points. And yes, that can compound, which means that if you fall behind on two of your trade lines on your credit report, then yes, you can lose anywhere from 100 to 200 points. So remember, the biggest key is to always make sure that your payments are made on time, every single time. Next chapter. 30% of your score is going to be your actual how much you owe. How much are you extended? How much credit card utilization have you put on your credit cards? Can you afford any more debt? And when lenders are looking to determine if they can actually give you a loan or not, they're looking at all of these different factors. Can you take on any more debt? Are you over 30% utilization on your credit card? Remember, anytime that you are over 30% utilization on your credit card, you're going to see an automatic decrease in your credit score. The rule of thumb is to keep your credit card utilization as close to zero as possible. You don't want to keep it at zero. You want to kind of use it, pay it off. But remember, anything over 30%, you're going to see a decrease in your score. So the rule of thumb is to always keep your credit composition, your credit utilization under 30%. Next chapter. The next part of your credit score composition is going to be 15% of your score, and this is your length of history. So we're talking about exactly how long did you actually have that trade line. I see many mistakes with credit, and people get frustrated. They want to raise their score, so they think the solution is to cut up all of their credit cards and call them and cancel all your credit cards. No, never do that. That's the number one crucial, critical mistake that you can make as far as raising your credit. You always want to remember the first important key about length of history is keep any actively reporting trade lines open. Keep them open, just discipline yourself not to use them, because when you actually close down that trade line, you actually close down 15% of your score. Next chapter. 10% of your score is going to be based off of your credit types. So this is going to be a healthy balance between revolving and installment accounts. Lenders want to see that you have revolving accounts, such as your credit cards. Revolving accounts, they revolve over a period of time, and typically they can go on for a very long time. They can never cancel out unless you as the consumer or the company decides that they want to part ways. Other type of trade lines in your credit report is going to be your installment account. These are things that's going to end over a period of time, such as your auto loan. You might have that for 5 years, or your mortgage loan. You might have that for a 30-year mortgage loan. Remember, you want to have a healthy balance between your revolving account and your installment account. And remember, that makes up 10% of your credit score.